the teams are ready to go. Let's have a look at the lineups here. Let's start with Luftwaffles. We'll call them for Waffles for now, because that is a mouthful. Oh, the puns. Cobalt, Hangman, Lodrim, Mike34, Scheibel, Tufftone, Vitney, and Zeter Q. And we will probably see Cobalt squad taking the helicopter and Vitney going in the tank. Some players to look out for as infantry, we'll see Tufftone and Lodrim and Zeter Q doing a lot of groundwork. And on the US team, we have Braino, Bonzi, Santa, Logic, Hitman Logics, Hoogeld, Kibzy, Mr. Hansen, and Pumbaa. And Mr. Hansen and Pumbaa should be doing a lot of groundwork for infantry. Reyno.
Oh my god. Is that Logix, the team Logix?
I believe so. Very good. Very, very good jet.
I haven't seen them in forever.
But they are off here, ladies and gentlemen. Let's start the bronze match here on the BCL Finals. 8v8.
Yeah, definitely looking forward to this. What do you think the breakouts are going to really focus on here, though, first off, just as we are starting to clash there in the middle?
Well, you know, the two helicopter pilots are trying to push. I don't know how many players are in Scheibel's helicopter from Waffles. It is him by alone. But Braino does manage to disable the helicopter, and he's going to bail. And Luftwaffles already secured that roof control straight away. Well, we do have Zeter Q.
Bronze just killed the tank. He just killed the tank for Waffles right at the very start of the match. Is Top's tank still? Oh my god, that's a huge win right there. I have no clue how they did not spot that GI Jeep. But that is a massive win right here for Tops at the beginning.
Yeah, it's that crucial asset is now out of the question. But we do have a push here from Hitman, trying to get stuck on that tree, rushing to Alpha. But Cobalt has been aware and knows that there is this push coming on to Alpha right now, and he can hopefully stop it. He has that G18, the pocket AEK. But will Hitman, he manages to spot him again. This Alpha gimme flag will hopefully not fall over to anyone. And the focus is right here in the middle between Charlie and Delta. Bravo falling over to Tops and Charlie falling over to Waffles. A little bit of stand-up, but Santa is being fairly aggressive here, going towards the middle. You tend to see the tank either staying on one or either side of the objective, usually towards the Charlie spawns. But takes out Scheibel there, predicting the HMG. And is there anyone going?
Really interesting, though, seeing them having these extra spawns coming in over here onto A instead of reinforcing the middle of these sites, because, you know, they did have C there for a while. Losing the middle flags, definitely not good. And the fact that you do have the support of your tank there, you know, you think you'd be able to push it a little bit more. But I think one of the things that hurt Tops at the moment is the fact that we still see the transport chopper up and alive and flying around. And while, you know, we did say, you do need to keep some pressure up in the air, he wasn't really doing anything. He wasn't going in for a back cap. Trying to get those spawns off. He wasn't setting up on top of the roof. He doesn't doing anything except for just flying in the backfield. And with only 8 people on your team, you need as many people on the ground to cap flags. If you're not fighting on a flag, if you're not capping a flag or killing a vehicle, then you're really not helping your team a whole lot.
Yeah, we saw Hitman was on that Alpha point. He managed to get 4 Waffle players before he eventually got taken out there, running low health. But that was a big distraction for the Waffles team to, you know, yeah, they were throwing so many bodies to try and clear up that mess on Alpha objective. And we do have Zeter Q on the roof here for Charlie objective, trying to get a little information and find out what's going on. But that Charlie objective is being capped towards Tops right now without any of them on the flag. They have the roof control, but they're powerless up here in this situation.
I have to say, you know, Tops really missed a good opportunity there to get a leg up on Waffles. If you take a look at it now, the tank was up, or is up, rather. It is getting pushed back. Well, they lose it just now again, but, I mean, with the way the infantry was playing there in the last one, I don't really know how much it's going to affect the game, because even with that tank being down, the air being down, with everything really being in the favor of, I almost said Logix there because I was looking at Hitman, but of Tops, then they didn't capitalize on it. They didn't press that advantage. So kind of a little bit concerned there, you know, like, are they just not confident in their play or what the deal was?
I don't know. I think they're focusing to just get these two center flags here. There's Tufftone here could potentially go for this back cap and take that gimme flag, the Delta objective, but he's trying to get rid of that tank, which does get taken out there eventually. And so that will be a little bit easier for him. And Tufftone's setting up some slams straight away to make sure that tank doesn't rush. Well, if it does rush in, he's going to have a bad time just trying to contest this. But Nanta is dead there, as Tough Tone is trying to pick up the kills, but unfortunately he's just outgunned there. And the helicopter.
Yeah, I like what Colt was doing over here on top of the roof. He's trying to get that transport chopper down as fast as possible, and he's not letting them really relax too much on trying to easily get up into that B site. He does finally end up going down, but I mean, if you look at the map right there, they have a really good control of the sites. I mean, they have CB handedly in control. They did lose the roofs over there onto Bravo, but that's not a big thing over on the B side because you can get down into tunnels. And we also did see a drop over here onto Alpha, but there's already two people that are waiting. The tanker is probably going to be back or taking the place of the tanker and coming back and being in that reserve position. But, you know, it's just not looking good here for Tops. I mean, they kind of had a bumpy start, or they had a good start, but they didn't capitalize on it. And now it's kind of starting to show. You're seeing just a little bit of the lead chip away here. And, you know, this is what Zabud is really famous for, in my opinion, is because it's a four flag map, you get a little bit of a lead. And that little bit of a lead is actually very, very hard to come back from.
Yeah, exactly. It's all down to the frags now, but Tops are, they did manage to secure this Charlie objective, and they're focusing on it. But I just see that Waffles, they're just so well spread out. Tough Tone here watching the spawns. He knows that Charlie objective is in control for Tops, and he can quickly find out or spot out any sort of spawns coming in. But Charlie is falling over to Waffles right now, and that lead is just gonna continue staying in their favor. And Alpha, another pushing again. Hitman just pushing the gimme flags. Really being, you know, it's good that he's doing this. It's good that he's putting this pressure on. He's distracting Waffles, making them thin out in the middle to give Tops a little bit more breathing space to push onto these center objectives. And Hitman is doing pretty well, but as I said, so he gets taken out by Bonzi there.
You know, I would agree with that, right? You know what you were saying there. All flags flashing for the most part, or will be flashing if this guy dies over here on D. But you know, I would agree with that statement right there, with Hitman doing a great job, you know, spreading them out. But the problem though is that we are seeing Waffles already rotating for a back cap of their own. They already have Sheba over here onto that D site. So even if they lose A, it's not really going to be that much of an impact. They're going to be able to get that D site fast. You can see the spawns now coming back in. That tank should be able to clean it up, you hope anyways. But with a big spawn bomb like this, you know, he's got to be very careful not to get trapped in these small little narrow areas. But what you really got to focus on if you're Tops right now is if you can't cap these middle flags right now and you can get A, you need to get your tank in such a position to where he can stay alive and tie up as many people they can on Delta Flag. And if you can tie up at least 3 to 4 players on D, which he has been able to do so far, you're going to be having much easier time on the rest of the flags on defending.
Yeah, and then we have the Charlie falling over to Pops. And Santa, considering in what situation he's in right now with all these engineers pushing him, he's surviving with that 26 health on and even getting some repairs on straight away. But you know, that Delta objective is not contested in the favor for Tops. Tough Tone is going to stay alive here, set up another slam trap, but Bravo will fall over. But there is Scheibel here on roof control, not going to be doing much apart from trying to give some information and maybe someone can spawn. And he does have Tough Tone as the dead spawn to give him some assistance on this Bravo flag and stop it from being capped.
Yeah, you know, it's really interesting here. You know, do we normally see the very, very aggressive tank play that we had at the very beginning of this match as a normality for the Euro scene? Because, you know, like I said, I come from a 10v10 background mostly, which is the Americas. And most of the time you see a very defensive tank play coming out from them. And seeing the tanks go down this frequently is almost unheard of in tens. So, I mean, is this like a normal deal, or are these guys just that aggressive?
I think, they really want to. We got to think about it in the terms of that they really want this third place. They want to win this bronze match. They want to, for them, this could be the last competitive Battlefield 4 round before the next title comes out. And so maybe they're just, they could be YOLOing it with, trying to risk it, doing these really aggressive plays. I usually tend to see tanks not going further past the. Like kind of that bridge in between Charlie and Bravo. They usually kind of stay past that line unless there is a specific reason to rush the gimme flag for either team. But Santa's being fairly aggressive and trying to lure Vitney out, and Vitney is just on low health, no repairs coming in to help him out. and he's just gonna, he's not gonna do well with Pumbaa popping off an RPG right next to him.
Yeah, I have to say, you know, normally, in my opinion, US tank can play slightly aggressive. Ooh, is that some slams coming down? It is. Sheeble there trying to trap that tank from tops in, and he's going to back up right over those slams. Boom, there he goes. He is going to get hurt quite a bit, down to 45 health on that tank. But, you know, that tank can get aggressive to a point as long as he has infantry back with him. It's the Russian side that I'm most concerned with. You know, you really need the baby, that A flag, because it is so hard to get players up in those buildings and go for those back caps. Tops is now going to be able to cap that over, so they've finally been able to get a three cap going down, 154 to 149. They have done a fantastic job so far of not letting Waffles run away with this match when they did have that slight little lead, and they're actually taking the lead change right now. So, This is actually looking good. Maybe they're a little bit cold there going into this match, but they're starting to turn things around.
Yeah, and we saw that Santa got taken out at the same time as Vitney, but with Santa being taken out, Vitney will be able to spawn in quicker and do some, give some assistance and hopefully push up to the center flags and try and help that Charlie flag from be returned to the control of Waffles. But Hitman is just... he's still here on Alpha Objective, and I can relate to him to a player from Raven, which is Gump. And we see Raven doing the same, we see Gump doing the same kind of moves and pushing these gimme flags, and really, he knows his positioning. They know where they should be, where is it difficult to find a player like you. They're these ninjas pushing in onto these objectives and giving things a bad time, but Alpha is in control, and there's going to be one player staying back to stop the burn of Alpha, while Charlie begins to blink, an instant exchange there to Bravo, with Tops claiming that objective. But let's see how things pan out here on Charlie objective, with Hogild slowly contesting this flag, and it looks like Tops are going to win the center objective. Oh no, but he gets duked from above by Hangman, getting that roof control.
Yeah, this is looking really good fight right now, I would have to say, for Tops. I mean, they are kind of just, you know, that bleed slowly going into the favor right now, Waffles, but they've done a really good job of being able to keep them, for the most part, off of the flag. You know, they have to have those guys up on top of the roofs and try and get some of those top-down shots coming in, but they've been able to delay any kind of a burn on this flag for quite a while. Now they have a 20-ticket lead in their advantage, and you know, at the moment, Waffles, they're trying to get bodies in there as quickly as possible. Now down to only two on C. There's the push now to try and rotate back over there to that Bravo site, but you know, Tops should be able to cap C over. They will be able to, I think, keep that two flag burn. And now with both of the tanks up and running here, I'm hoping that we see a decent tank battle going in, but no, Waffles does have to go ahead and back up, get back over here towards that Alpha side.
Yeah, there's that Hitman staying alive on that Alpha objective. With, I know Waffles decided to, you know, abandon that post, or they got rid of Hitman, but he was able to get quickly back in onto the objective with a quad bike. And Vinny's just going to be distracted, and is not very useful for, you know, for the Waffle guys to get the assistance they need onto Charlie. But with them swarming this objective right now, it could be in their favor. Pumbaa is the only one remaining alive on the roof. He does have two dead spawns who could help him out now. He does have the information needed and the support of the tank as well to stop this push. But I think no one really from Waffles could be going for Delta objective. The helicopter is up. Vitney taken to the skies right now, but a three flag hold for Tops at the time being. And they wasted that helicopter, and hopefully they won't. No one from Tops will pick it up, and you know, because the worst thing is when you have you lose your transport. And that's can be a really crucial key for you to have.
It can be a crucial point, but honestly, right now Tops needs boots on the ground in order to defend these flags, and I think they've done a pretty decent job at doing that. As long as they can just continuously get these kills, there. For the most part, they're outnumbering them on the flags. Again, they've taken down the armor right here for Waffles, so they do have that little bit of an extra chess piece, like we said before, in their back pocket. And you know, Santa is playing now like I like to see the tankers play on this map, especially on the U.S. side. He's kind of playing passively over onto Delta and Charlie. He's playing in between those two flags, and when his infantry players move up, he moves up with them, gives them a little bit of support. That's the way you use that tank. You're not there just to go in and use it as a bang bus, you know, trying to get as many kills as possible. No, you're there to support support your infantry guys and try and be that little bit of extra something that is able to push you over the edge and get that flag cap.
Yeah, and I mean, I'm looking at Bravo objective here. Kibbs staying alive in that MRAP, but Lodra manages to take him out with that Scar-H. And I don't know, Santa is aware of his presence there, manages to drop a incendiary grenade and takes out Lodrim, and Bravo does get back into the control for Waffles, and now it is down to the kills a little bit to try and even the scores, but with the, what is that, 40 ticket lead right now?
Yeah, it's a 50 ticket lead at the moment, so I mean, this is actually a really big deal. Like what you're saying before, you know, if you can get any kind of a lead, because it goes down to a 2-2 standoff, you can pretty much just go off of kills at that point. And to be completely honest, you know, right now, at overall kills, we're seeing the U.S. team doing a fairly decent job, I think, overall. They've had more luck between both of their squads surviving in some of these fights. You can see a failed push going on to that Delta site. So Waffles now having to spawn back in, try and maybe push over here onto this B site. Big push actually coming onto Bravo, as we do see Vitan trying to get his tank into a position to actually cause some damage, and another drop coming in over onto the C side. But on the other team, we have a push coming in onto Alpha because there is nobody back there to defend it. So they may get this B site. They may even get Charlie site here for Waffles. Mm. But they're going to lose A, and it will go back to a 2-2 standoff.
Yeah, and like this is always a... I mean, I get a question for you about the roof positioning on Zavod. Yes, it is important. Yes, you do get a lot of information. Yes, you can be a vital spawn point for your team to push an objective with the whole squad spawning in and doing a, you know, big push. But there are the downsides to this, and that is you are not able to, you know, push the objective. You lose a player or two just by having this roof control. And I guess the hard part and what makes a good team a good team is deciding whether to use these positions and keep them or to kind of call it off.
Well, you know, basically right there, you know, yeah, it's all a judgment call as to how long you stay up on the roofs. You don't want your entire team up on the roofs. What you want is one guy sitting up on top of roofs. He's there, like you said, provide information on oncoming enemy players. He's there to provide that spawn point, and he's also there to try and get some shots inside the buildings from on top of those roofs. Obviously, the B roofs are a lot less valuable just because they can get inside the tunnels, they can get up underneath, and it's almost impossible in order to weed them out from the rooftops, but you still need to have that control. And I mean, as if I was a captain, if I was a play caller, I would want somebody up on top of the roofs, at least one at almost all times, just because that is a very crucial position to have. Now, if we're going to go down to crunch time, and we need to have some bodies on flags like right now, as it's 15 tickets to 110, yes, I would put everybody on a flag as fast as possible, but at the moment, it's just looking like Tops has too much control on the map. I mean, they need to do a power burn here for Waffles very fast, and that might happen over here onto Delta.
Yeah, and one ticket remaining, that spawn is going to cost them that round. But 110 tickets is not too difficult of a situation for them to be in right now to go into round two. But this is the choice of Luftwaffles. So shall see how they will do on their choice, and especially
Kind of a good score, you know, right there for the Waffles. I would prefer to have it down somewhere around 80 to like 90 tickets or so. Just get it down below that triple digit mark. But you know, to be completely honest, the U.S. side of this map, in my opinion, is the easier side for a couple of reasons. One, that Delta flag is pretty darn easy to defend with your tank. Like I said before, that tank can pretty much move in between Delta and Charlie, go in between those two flags. He has a lot of cover, and his infantry players can push in onto those two flags and reinforce quite easily. It's very clear and open onto Delta. You can see things coming at you from quite a distance, and there's not a whole lot of hiding places. Yes, you can get in the train cars, and they can be annoying, but the thing is that you can basically stall out that flag, and if they want to put more players onto that Delta site to try and just sit in a cart and just burn a flag, that opens it up on the other parts of the map. The second thing that the US side has the advantage on is that alpha site. You can get in those buildings. You can hide in so many corners. You can get on top of the rooftops with the transport chopper. That tank has almost no way of taking you down. And that's really what the tanks mainly play is. They play as that defending, you know, that goalie almost. They're in the back there just to make sure that they have their own gimme flag. By the way, gimme flag, when I do say that, guys, for viewing, that is the first flag that you come to. It's a gimme. It's almost like here you go to start out the round. So on that gimme flag for that A, for the Russian team on A, very difficult to defend if you have somebody that is sitting up on top of those roofs or just walking around in those buildings. And it ties up your tank. It ties up some infantry players to try and weed them out. So I think now that we flip sides, Tops is going to have a lot harder time, especially if they come out playing like they did at the beginning of round number one. It's definitely not going to look good. I mean, you could very well possibly see an all cap coming out at the very beginning. That's what I was saying before. You know, Tops missed a very good opportunity when they had that tank down right at the start and the chopper to go in for a very aggressive push and possibly a four cap there to A. So, you know, Waffles, we'll see if they're going to be able to capitalize on it. But yeah, like you said, 110 tickets, not too scary to come back from. Remember, guys, the way this is going to be scored is we're going to be taking the greatest ticket count from both of these rounds, and whoever has the most tickets at the end of two rounds will be the winner for this map. So, you know, you can kind of give up a round. It's not going to matter too much. But they definitely need to keep their nose to the grindstone. They need to be careful here not to get too lack here from Tops, as Waffles has an absolute chance of coming back and winning.
Yeah, and well, for Waffles to come in and have a chance of winning this round.
But yeah, I think, is that not what I said? Did I say Tops?
You said Tops.
Oh. Well.
It's all right.
They both have an opportunity of winning this round, but I think that Waffles has the advantages going in their favor this time. Like I said, with having that Delta flag on their side, easy defend, and then also having a better attacking gimme flag onto A site. So we'll see how they play this out. And I want to see – I really want to see if they go for an aggressive Jeep push onto a back flag. Before, we didn't have that. We had no aggressive pushes going out towards the gimme flags. Instead, what they elected to do was go in for GI Jeeps for the tanks. And then a lot of pressure onto the middle flags, a lot of pressure on C and B with those spawns. So I'm kind of curious if maybe they switch it up a little bit here.
Yeah, you say, you tend to see see teams primarily focusing on these two center objectives because Bravo and Charlie are in such close proximity. They're easy to control. You can get that information if you have roof control in your favor as well. And it seems to be a favorite thing to do. We start the match, we break out, we do a quick push to these center flags, and maybe we'll have that one player going for the other team's gimme flag. But it's always interesting to see how they do it. But watching these eight games for the past two seasons, it usually ends up with there being a big push to the center, 2-1 flag, another 2-2 Charlie. Then you have two guys on the roofs and one guy in the tank, one guy on LAV. And the tank will usually stay behind to cap the gimme flag. But the only difference is that's kind of deciding, does the tank act aggressive? Does he go straight towards the middle objectives and let one infantry cap it and keep that vehicle asset in an aggressive stance, or do they just let it cap and wait until they have a bit more information and assign, okay, you need to go for Bravo because it's been capped and that's where we need the armor to be on at this point. But with that being said, it's time for us to start round two here on map one, the choice of Waffles. 3 seconds on the clock. Let's see how things kick off. And maybe a sneaky tank shot from the Tops tanker. You see Santa could potentially drive up this hill.
Nope, not looking like he's going to do it. So he's gonna go for a shot there, and he doesn't have missing. Would have been fantastic if he did hit that though. As I said, I have completely lost myself before. I have seen a couple of shots like that. In fact, I did in a finals match. It was insane. And I think it was like 4,000 players watching it as well. So it was pretty awesome. But yeah, I mean, very aggressive play coming out for the tanks right away. We see absolutely nobody really going in for a back rage. Another Geo Jeep though coming in from tops. That's going to be bronze to try and get to that tank of their opponents. Not going to happen this time. Again, it's very easy to see what's coming in your way onto that Delta flag, so not going to have as much luck as we did before. But this is looking pretty normal. No, do not. He is not going to get this. No, he is not going to be able to get this. Bronze here is doing a fantastic job of staying alive.
No!
Oh my God! He gets it. He dodges. He weaves it. And he, I don't even know. You are not supposed to be able to do that.
Yeah, Vitney was totally at an advantage. He had a lot of information, a lot of time to respond, but Bonzi was just weaving, and I think it was God's will. He managed to survive this, and Hitman even getting a roadkill on his approach to Delta, and tops are on Delta. It is cleared for the time being. Only one player to contest against, and that is Bonzi, but he gets taken out there by Scheibel from Waffles, and we have Santa coming in now onto this Charlie objective. But I thought in the start, even though that tank was taken out for Waffles, I thought the breakout was a lot faster and a lot smoother from Waffles than tops. But Braino did manage to shoot down the transport helicopter, and now we have the push going on to Bravo to try and secure this objective. And there we do. Bravo is in control. Pumba the only one remaining.
And you know, again, we're seeing a really good opportunity being wasted by tops. Why are they using their transport chopper like this? That is a guy that could be there burning flags right now, helping out their team on going for some backdrops. Delta did not go their way. We do see Hitman now dropping out as their transport chopper is going to die. Both of those players end up getting killed. That was wasted life. There are only three players left up and alive right now for the total tops team. They have to wait for those respawns, and guess what? They don't even have control right now of the lead, even with that fantastic play that we saw with another backrage coming in. It's not looking good right now.
Not at all. But we have a big push here from tops with three players on the roofs, which you were saying earlier. Very difficult for the tank to take out. But Cobalt actually gets taken out, but he manages to land one shot, do a little bit of damage onto Santa in that tank. Tough Tone here as well, getting another one. But it's going to be, they need a lot more firepower on that tank to do any sort of damage. But Bravo and Charlie falling over to tops, as we see. And Scheibel's the only one remaining here. But he gets taken out by a Kobe nade from Braino. that's kind of the end of the story. There seems to be no presence from Waffles except for this Bravo roof. And they're just waiting for an opportunity. It seems they're being very hesitant. Probably they don't have enough information if they should push this objective or not. But I think they are taking the chance right now.
I like this play, though, coming out from Santa. I like the way he's playing his flag. He's not trying to win it by himself. We only have one infantry player that is going to be dedicating himself to try and help the tank clear out these buildings. It's exactly the way they need to play this right here. They do have control of that Charlie flag, and they're going in for a back rage over onto Delta. Bronze is going to be there to burn it. Remember, there's no tank, so there's not really going to be any defensive positioning or defensive players sitting on this flag. And, you know, even with them losing out on this A site, and they very well may take it back, actually, as Cobalt is not sitting up on top of the roofs, they are going to be sitting really, really pretty here with a possible 3-cap.
Yeah, and we did have Bonzi in the meantime rotating around here, but he's showing his body just through that building, giving enough information for Vitney to know where to place that shell and take him out there, as Delta will remain grayed out. No spawns to come in, as we do have a cautious approach here onto Bravo objective from Mr. Hansen. And does he have anyone to contest against as he goes and takes out that one player from Waffles? And it seems to be easy pickings for this Bravo objective right now. It's just Zetero here giving a, well, being a medic on the roof. It would be a much better situation if he was an engineer. But Santa is being very passive. Push from Cobalt onto Alpha, even potentially a back shot onto that. No C4 Jeeps from Waffles yet. We haven't seen any. We saw two already from tops. And yeah, like as you said, they haven't really capitalized on that those situations.
Yeah, I think Waffles, though, they're not too worried about trying to go in for. I mean, that's a legitimate tactic. I'm not gonna lie there. It's a legitimate tactic to go for those C4 Jeeps, but it's kind of a little bit cheesy, and you're taking a little bit of a gamble with, you know, expending a guy to run around the map. He's not really involved in doing anything for, you know, 10, 15, 20 seconds sometimes, and he might just end up getting spotted out and dying. But, you know, at the moment, we do see a pretty decent push coming in. Oh, wow, look at Santa right now getting super aggressive here. He's on the other side of the map. He's in enemy territory, and he is going to go ahead and just push in on top of Venti. I don't know if he's going to be able to survive here because the infantry players are here as well, and he does end up going down. So this is going to be a little bit of an awkward position for Tops to be in. They have both of the gimme flags. They're going to be able to control D and A with their tank on the U.S. side of the map. So these infantry players that are going to be spawning in from Waffles are going to be sandwiched between two enemies.
Not a good situation to be in right now. Tough Tone here, the last one kind of close to Delta objective. They're going to have to reset and push in from the U.S. side. We do see Scheibel spawning in to the transport helicopter as Alpha is slowly being contested. We see Santa returning back to a more defensive position, but there are two infantry already on the case. A 2v3 situation on Alpha, and one battle being won there with Waffles getting one more body on the objective. But Hitman is just going to wait and be patient. And now this is the thing, like with 8v8, 8v8 teaches you patience. It teaches you not just to run and gun, try and get kills and look and have a nice pretty KD. It's about waiting and being like, am I important right now? Am I needed to be in this position? Can I help my team by being here? Should I reveal myself? Should I engage? And those kind of small decision making nuances can really set a player or team apart with their patience.
Yeah, well, right now, I mean, this is not looking good here for Tops. Tops has about, I don't know, about 80 tickets or so here to work with. And the reason why we say that, guys, is because if they go below 110 tickets, it'll be impossible for them to actually win this map. Because, again, it's the total ticket count at the end of both rounds that will determine the victor. So, you know, they need to go ahead and kick it into high gear. We are seeing them getting control of the middle side of the map. It looks like Delta will now be in their control as well. Still, the other side of the map's gimme. Top still has their tank up as well, so he's going to be able to do a little bit of damage, but they need to hold this 3 cap for as long as possible. I mean, this is going to be very important for them to try and gain at least like maybe a 40 ticket bleed here.
Just some terrible aiming there going on from a Waffles player as Kibzy does take out that guy. Didn't manage to catch it, but it seems like the teams have lost their momentum a little bit. It seems a lot more cautious gameplay. It's a little bit more decision-making going on. It just seems they aren't rushing as much as they were in the very start of the game. We had like that moment of silence on the battlefield here, but Kibzy is being aggressive. He wants the kills, gets this one kill into Scheibel, but unfortunately, Lodrim takes him out with a refrag there. Prowl is in control. Hogel trying to push up, gets Hangman, but flanked from the right side by Lodrim.
Yeah, so not the greatest, you know, burn that we saw from Tops there. They are going to be settling it back to a 2-2 split. The armor is down now for them, so that's not looking good at all. Vinny is going to be able to have a pretty easy time on just picking apart some of these random infantry players that are trying to push in onto the middle flags here. We do have a possible back rage coming in. I don't know where Hansen's actually going, but I spotted out the Cobalt. That's where he's going. But he's not really going to do much in that position. Bronze now with a GI Jeep down towards the south, as well as Hitman going in for a back rage. So that could get very interesting on the tank. I think Vitney has spotted. Yeah, he has spotted it out. So he knows what's coming his way. And he shouldn't get completely taken down once again. But you never know. He's able to survive one shot here. Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. This is very exciting. Vinny, how is he not missing? How he's missing his shots?
What? I don't even know.
The C4 Jeep is still up. Bonzi. Oh, but he does get taken out there eventually. Vinny finally connecting the shots onto there. Because that would have been a shame to see Vinny go down again.
To be honest, it looked like he dusted him on a Jeep. Which is like, what? But yeah, he does get that kill. He backs up. He's like, all right, we're going to go ahead and make sure that we're going to be safe and repaired up and alive. But Waffles now basically taking control of the middle of the map. They did spawn, or I'm not sorry, spawn, but they did kill two more players from Tops. Tops spawning outside to the north there. One of the disadvantages of not having that person up on top of the roof spawning in is that you have to now walk towards the flag if you do spawn on it. So should be able to get the gray out and possibly the burn in their favor, which will give them the three flag burn overall and the bleed back in their favor as they do take the lead with 166 to 167 in just a few seconds.
Yeah, I mean, looking to be a bit close, very, very close game. Only two ticket difference. But Tops can afford to fall below 110 tickets. If Waffles fall below 110 tickets, the match goes straight to Tops. So they do have a little bit of breathing space. Just as long as they can force the tickets for Luftwaffles to drop below 110, then Waffles will lose the round and it will get 1.2 Tops. However, let's see what's happening here on Charlie objective. We have Kibbs trying to get on this Charlie. I keep wanting to call it Delta, not Conquest Large.
No, right now, you know, 110 tickets, it's looking very, very scary. Waffles is sitting in a fantastic position. We have about 38 tickets left to go for Tops in order to make this happen before the first map is kind of done and over with. This is a best of three, so they do have a second opportunity on that Dawnbreaker map to try and take it to a third. But look at the tank fight that's going to be happening there towards the north. And it looks like Tops is going to be in trouble, but I think both tanks ended up getting picked up. But no, Santa somehow able to stay alive. He does a little bit of repairing there just to make sure that he can get his tank to a safer position. That was an interesting fight right there.
A tough tone trying to drop a couple of slams onto Santa, but this wasn't enough. Santa's able to roll free here. But let's see, Charlie is the two flag hold four Tops, and we do have a small push coming in onto Bravo objective. It's Hansen on the roofs. And we're seeing a little bit more of a pattern here. The players, the same players appearing on the roofs. And since we're denying Weasel any access to that Bravo roof there, as two of his squad mates jump down to try and contest his Bravo objective. But Hansen is taken out there by ZTRQ, getting the drop on him. But Bravo was grayed out, so it's going to be a little bit of a different situation for Waffles to get back down. And then there's no tank. Vitney is down. Santa is road kills Vitney there by backing up over him, so Vitney wasn't able to try to get a repair tool kill if that's what he was trying to do. But now his lifeless body clings to that tank. And with Delta, the burn has just stopped with Tough Tone spawning in along with Vitney.
Yeah, that's a shame right there, because that was really there. I mean, we have like maybe one opportunity here for Tops to really be able to get a good lead and try and hold it. Now, I know a lot of you guys are like, there's no way they're going to be able to burn down 147 tickets with only basically 20 tickets left. Yeah, it is definitely possible. We've seen it before. If they can get a three cap hold and they can prevent any kind of back caps going down, it is definitely possible. I've seen it many, many times before. But at the moment, it's looking like Waffles is a little bit too good on their spawns. They're definitely doing a great job on their comms on getting these really good fast burns. Almost losing out there onto Delta. Came down to only one player left up alive. So that Waffles getting really, really close there in order to basically bring this to a 2-2 flag standoff, as we are now 129 to 139. Still the lead here for Waffles, as well as that first round win.
Yeah. But, just trying to think, like, so we do have Dawnbreaker coming up soon as the second round, and Tops could potentially, could easily steamroll over Waffles with that helicopter team, and if they don't make the same mistakes they made in the semifinals, which was a shame. Because we weren't really able to see the gameplay from Brano and Zero, but the US team only have 23 tickets to work with. But maybe they can just burn out these 130 tickets from ops?
This is pretty much over. I mean, we're going to see Waffles, I think, being able to win this pretty easily here. You know, they seem to be able to stabilize on a lot of these pushes that Tops are making. Tops are able to get, you know, a 3-flag or potential 3-flag burn, but the respawns are just too strong here for Waffles. They've been able to mass in their reinforcements perfectly. Just perfectly. So as you can see right now, they are slowing down the burn there onto Delta. In fact, they canceled it out there, so they might be able just to go ahead and keep that for a win themselves. We do see a back rage though coming in. Waffles is now going to be getting attacked from the backside potentially here. Yeah, he's going to get a couple of shots. Ooh, nice shot there from Vitney, as we are going to be seeing him, I think, just trying to get those repairs up as quickly as possible. So, but the middle flag now going over into the favor of Tops here, as well as with that A-burn in their back pocket. So they will be able to get that 3-flag cap.
Yeah, so, yeah, Tops, you know, they do have some breathing space. They got to wait just those 5 tickets. That bleed is being very, very dangerous right now. And for them to do a quick burn into Charlie, Waffles pulling out all the stops here, trying to get onto this objective. But I don't think they can do it. As it is, GG and Tops win round, well, map 1 in this best of 3. GG to Tops. Proclaiming that victory. So great, great start. Very close rounds. A lot better gameplay on the second round here. Teams working a little bit better, more in sync. And as you said, Tops came out a little bit cold on round 1 and warmed up and got their heads back into the game here. And well, it paid off with their persistence to secure a victory on the first map.
Yeah, they had a really rough time in that first round, but overall looking pretty decent going into Dawnbreaker. Infantry plays, I think, were kind of mellowing out. Like we saw a little bit of what looked like Waffles just really doing well infantry-wise in the first round, but I think really in the second round, both teams are feeling pretty good. They're trading out pretty consistently there in the middle of flags. Nobody really had a firm control like we saw in that previous match, or I'm sorry, previous round. I think what maybe the longest hold that we saw that was a 3-flag was probably maybe 45 seconds to a minute at most. But overall, I mean, it was very, very even, very close. Both these teams now feeling good, I think. And Dawnbreaker should be a pretty interesting match, I think.
One second, Brett. I'm just getting the server ready to switch on over to the next map. Or I'm not sure if they are going to play it out to the very end. But for the time being...
Yeah, it's looking like they are just... Well, GG's already been thrown out, so they know they have already got the win in their back pocket. So, thank you guys for showing up and watching. You know, definitely appreciate all of you watching the stream. Make sure you do go ahead, share it to everybody you know. Get it on Facebook, get it on Twitter. Get as many people involved here in the stream. This is a very exciting moment here for the competitive scene in Battlefield. First time that we've been on the main Battlefield channel, and hopefully we're going to be seeing many, many more coming up in the future.